Recent study abroad programs are educating themselves on the effect of the Zika virus as they travel to areas of outbreak.
And they didn't even have a name for it at the time until like halfway through.
The mystery of this virus has many professionals looking for an answer.
As scientists are trying to discover if there is a link between the mosquito bite and the birth defects that are happening.
The Zika virus and its effects. It's our top story tonight on LCTV News.
Good evening. I'm Dimitri Villanueva alongside Caroline Fogleton. The CDC has declared a public health emergency for Zika virus. As you can see here on the map, several states have reported cases of the virus, all of these being travel-associated cases. Florida with 9 cases, Texas reporting 8, and Illinois reporting 3.
With study abroad, international students, and service trips, I took a further look at what Loris is doing about this new epidemic.
No one ever told us about the Zika virus, and we didn't hear about it until we got there, and they didn't even have a name for it at the time until like halfway through.
Zika is a Andes mosquito, and it's primarily found in Central and Southern Americas.
Traveling to these places only increases the risk of getting the Zika virus.
People become ill. It generally is more of a mild illness. You know, you might be sick up to a week.
Symptoms of the virus reported by the Center for Disease Control are fever, rash, joint pain, and red eyes.
But of those that get bit by the mosquito, typically only about 20% become ill.
So how does this impact Loris?
The college is definitely monitoring the situation down there, being very forthright, sharing all the education with the students and the faculty members that are going along.
Spreading awareness is the number one priority for the study abroad program.
So unless things change, we'll just keep watching it.
That I'm fine for now. I mean, there's nothing that I could do to prevent it.
With LCTV News, I'm Caroline Fogleton. After speaking with the study abroad coordinator, she says that Loris is going to continue to monitor the locations affected by the Zika virus. LCTV is following this story closely. Stay tuned to mydubuque.com for more updates.
Those living in Dubuque and struggling to get by may be receiving help this coming year. The National League of Cities is introducing to Dubuque the Financial Inclusion Systems and City Leadership Cohort.
One of the things that is really important is to be financially included. So that means being able to get a bank account, making sure you're filing your taxes and getting your maximum refund.
The financial inclusion aims to collaborate with programs around Dubuque to help people ages 16 to 24 who aren't working or going to school and connect them with financial experts from banks and credit unions. With this program in place, the goal is to reduce the cycle of poverty among young adults in Dubuque. The Dubuque County Boards of Supervisors are searching for a new member. After the unexpected passing of Supervisor Tom Hancock, board members chose to forego a special election due to extra costs and appoint a new supervisor using an application process. The board plans to meet next week to finalize planning with a tentative decision date of Tuesday, March 8th. With the Iowa caucus last week, the New Hampshire primary last night, and Nevada and South Carolina around the corner, the race to the White House is in full swing. What were the results from the first two voting rounds, and how do they affect the future of this election? LCTV reporter Peyton Van Voorst gets up to date.
I'm here to caucus for Bernie Sanders.
Ben Carson.
Hillary Clinton.
Tonight I cast my vote for Rick Santorum.
Leading up to last week's caucus, presidential candidates of all varieties threw their pitch to Iowa.
And Dubuque and Loris see a lot of these candidates.
But aside from being the first up to bat, what's the big deal with Iowa?
While the results are mixed in terms of how predictive they are of the ultimate nominee, they are very helpful for the parties in terms of eliminating. They make the field smaller.
With three Republicans and one Democratic candidate dropping out of the race shortly after the Iowa caucus, every voting period can be a curveball.
In terms of the process, I've been surprised every day, basically.
Ted Cruz and Hillary Clinton won in Iowa. So how are the upcoming caucuses and primaries influenced by their preceding states?
You have to not just think about the election right ahead of you. So after New Hampshire for the Republicans, it goes to South Carolina. If you really want to kind of predict where this is going, look 2, 3, or 4 elections down the line.
And through it all, citizens continue to cheer for their favorite team.
I'm proud to be here tonight.
For LCTV News, I'm Peyton Van Voorst.
The New Hampshire primary ended up taking a bit of a turn from the results we saw in Iowa. Ted Cruz, who won the Republican side in Iowa, landed in third yesterday. Trump took first on the Republican side with 35.4% of votes, followed by John Kasich with 15.7%, and Ted Cruz in third with 11.7%. On the Democratic side, Bernie Sanders was a clear winner with a 60.2% of votes, and Hillary Clinton coming in second with 38.2%. Earlier today, Republican Carly Fiorina announced her withdrawal from the election. The next event, it will be held on Saturday, February 20th.
The cost of textbooks always puts a dent in the bank accounts of college students. One Laura student hopes to lighten the load of those heavy textbooks. Sophomore Troy Erickson created a new business this school year called Dubuque Cash for Books. The business offers an easy alternative for students to inexpensively buy and sell textbooks.
People can go to Dubuque Cash for Books on Facebook, click send message, and just send me a picture, an ISBN number, or just the titles of the books. We make a deal, and then we just go meet somewhere. It's mostly whatever's convenient for them.
Erickson is happy with the success his business has received so far and encourages students to check out his Facebook page for more information.
With the completion of the Super Bowl, AdMeter.usa Today releases their rankings of the top Super Bowl commercials for 2016. Topping the ranks is the Hyundai commercial, First Date. Humor seemed to be the theme for this year's variety of advertisements, but whether you used wiener dogs or a town full of Ryan Reynolds clones, landing a spot on the rankings is indeed a favorable outcome.
There's no other way I know of that an advertiser can reach 111 million people with one message. There just isn't.
Having your product advertised to an audience of over 100 million consumers makes paying $5 million for the commercial not all that bad.
Welcome to Good Burger. Oh wait, welcome to Loras College. Loras College Activities Board invited comedian and Nickelodeon star Kel Mitchell to Dubuque. Over 400 gathered in the Loras ballrooms to watch the stand-up comedy show. Known for his role in the 90s shows such as Kenan and Kel and All That, many of the fans in the crowd grew up with Kel Mitchell.
You always turn on Nickelodeon when you're a kid and you look at Kel Mitchell and you just smile watching that show.
But his motivation for stand-up comedy comes from a surprising source.
Well, most of the reason why I started doing college tours and stand-up was so that I could meet the fans and shake their hand, you know what I mean?
Students and faculty alike agree that the event was a great success. To check out more CAB events, go to mydohawk.com.
Sundown Mountain in Dubuque has made a lot of changes in hopes of bringing in more business to the slopes. I made a visit to check out the improvements to this popular family-owned ski resort.
It's been great. It's actually had more impact than I understood.
Sundown Mountain made a few major renovations over the summer.
Right from the beginning, the whole idea was to have a customer come in one door, get a ticket right there, get their boots, put them on, and get their skis, so they're always going the same direction. We want to have the customer take the fewest number of steps to get out on the hill.
Sundown moved all of the rental gear out of the North Lodge and into the new building. The North Lodge was renovated and now has a brand new cafeteria, bar, and gift shop.
We've got a lot of improvements in the building, so it's been a great asset for Sundown. It's just great to have the space to work with and help our customers.
With all of the new changes at Sundown, the renovations have brought in a better interest for skiers and snowboarders.
It's been thrilling, actually, and it's a weird business to be in because, you know, you got Mother Nature, and in the summertime, there's hardly anybody here. Right now, we have like 320 people here. If you haven't come out here before, it's an awesome place. I mean, people that tend to come out here are energetic, outgoing, and so as you're, you know, learning to ski or snowboard, I think you'll find that it's a pretty good vibe out here.
For LCTV News, I'm Dimitri Villanueva.
Enjoy a good book or a unique piece of art? The Carnegie Stout Public Library gives community members the opportunity to do both. Carnegie Stout hosted artists from around Dubuque at the Art at Your Library exhibit. During the reception, creators were free to express the inspiration behind their pieces.
For me, everything that you see, all the work that I've done, has been images that I've thought about, dreamt about, and just kind of stay with you. So you want to put that down on canvas.
One of the things I find that's probably the most nerve-wracking is a blank canvas, believe it or not. Sometimes I just have to put something on there just to get something started.
The artists also had the opportunity to greet visitors as they came to support local art. The pieces ranged from photographs to paintings to decorative candles. And now it's time for this week's Happy Joe's Trivia. You know how to play. We read the question and you send your guess to lctv@loras.edu or tweet us at lctv_news. First one with the correct answer wins.
All right, here we go. The Super Bowl is a 50-year tradition of football in America. However, in recent years, much of the Super Bowl's hype comes from the commercials. The Broncos took the football victory, but which commercial ad was named number one in ratings? Is it A, Hyundai First Date, B, Doritos Ultrasound, C, Mountain Dew Puppy Monkey Baby, or D, Budweiser Simply Put? Get your guesses in and we'll reveal the winner at the end of the show.
Now you're looking at a live shot where that Loras AWC, where the Dewhawks will be in action in just a few minutes. Sammy Graff will be there live. Stay tuned.
Hey Travis.
Get some friends, loser.
You all right, man?
Lean on me.
Thanks.
When you're not strong, and I'll be
character.
Your pass it on.
I'll help you carry.
A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
When you log on to MyDuhawk.com, you get more than just the news. You get the latest in all your local sports action, hard-hitting and breaking Dubuque headlines, up-to-date Laura stories, and everything else you need to know. My city, my school, my teams, and my news. It's all in one place. MyDuhawk.com, your Loris and Dubuque news source.
There was a packed house in the AWC for the men's basketball IIAC crosstown matchup. Loris came into the game at 6-3 in conference play, and we're hoping to get some revenge against the Spartans. Duhawk started the game with high energy. Justin to Justin, Van Wombeck to Schneider, and one gets the crowd on their feet. Then Van Wombeck to DeCanio for three. The freshman having fun putting his pistols away. The high energy did not stop from freshman DeMond George coast to coast, getting the Duhawks back in at 14-12. Mid-first half, and Van Wombeck, of course, getting it on the scoring action himself. Then Mirko Gerchich shows everyone that not only the young freshmen have the hustle, going coast to coast for two himself. Unfortunately, the dominant force of Andre Norris for the Spartans could not be stopped. On fire, feeling it. His showing was just too much for the Duhawks Spartans. Spartans take this one 77-62. Before the men, it was the women who took the court Saturday. Duhawks and Spartans in a close battle. Jump to the action in the third. Spartans not quite ready to back down. Jesse Kirkwood makes a three-pointer. Game now 45-40, Spartans. End of the fourth, Kat Cabrera at the line, down one. Ties things up, and we go to overtime. Spartans take the lead. Last-ditch effort for Lauren Stanich, throws it up, but it was not good enough for the Spartans. The Spartans take the momentum and sweep the game 70-64. Duhawks are in action right now in Waverly, taking on the Wartburg Knights. The top teams of the USHL Eastern Conference went head-to-head Saturday night at Mystique. Saints waste no time against rival Rough Riders. Keegan Ford sends this one to the slot. Mitchell Smith taps it in. Saints up 1-0. Cedar Rapids stays with them. 14th minute, Akin to Matt Felipe for the goal. And we're all tied up at one. Head to the second, the Saints light things up. Gordy Green with the snipe from the right circle so fast the camera nearly catches it. Dallas Dryads keeps things going. Takes a pass from Cole Gutman to get the goal for the Saints and the fans on their feet. With just 20 seconds left in the second, Mitchell Smith takes this one on his own, and he takes the goalie with him. Saints lead 4-2, but the Rough Riders don't quit. Back-to-back goals from Callahan Burke and Justin Cole tie things up and take this game to overtime. Saints fall 5-4.
It's how we respond now. We're responsible for our own actions and how we come back from this, and I think I trust in our leadership group and the group in there, and I think they'll do a great job.
The Saints take on Muskegon at home this weekend. The wrestling team took a trip up the boulevard to the Jim Fox Open held at the University of Dubuque. Seven teams competed in the late season tournament. At 197, freshman Blake Dirks taking on Zach Hanneman. Hanneman gains control on the ground and gets four back points. Takes the match 12-2. Meanwhile, Owasso Rain dominates Colin Heideman on the mat in 184. Heideman tries to wiggle out of the tight grasp of Arain, but eventually falls by pin. Arain finishes third overall. Alec Aragon of UD locks up with Gabe Pleasance. Pleasance shoots for the takedown, pulls Aragon back with one leg, and gets 2 points. Pleasance advances 7-6. Finally, at heavyweight, Nolan Smith of UD overpowers freshman Dylan Wagner in the second round for the pin and takes the win. Loris finished fourth out of seven teams. The wrestlers are getting ready for action right now in the AWC. Sammy Graff is reporting live on the scene. Sammy, what do you have for us?
Thanks, John. The Duhawks are getting ready to take on the Buena Vista Beavers in tonight's dual meet. As you mentioned, Duhawks are coming off a fourth place finish out of seven teams total. Some key players to keep an eye on are Awas Arain, Evan Weaver, and Malcolm Watson. This is the second to last meet in the regular season before Duhawks take on regionals. They will travel to Wartburg on Friday to complete their season. Regionals will take place in Dubuque at the Five Flags Center on Sunday, February 28th. That's all I have for you guys. Back to you, John.
Thanks, Sammy. Head over to the AWC to watch the Duhawks after the show. That's all for Sports Shorts. Demetri and Caroline, back to you.
Thanks, John. Coming up after the break, we'll reveal our Happy Joe's trivia winner.
And we'll say hello to a furry new addition to the Plumery Tales family right after this.
My father taught me a lot about life without ever saying a word. When I was a little girl, my friends were all just like me. His never were.
Hello, hello.
Didn't you bring them, George?
I thought you were
No, no, I brought them last time.
Huh? You're all right. I forgot. All right, so all right. We'll be with
I used to wonder, why would a Jew, a Christian, and a Muslim ever get together?
It was him!
And then I finally got it. They had a lot more in common than donuts.
Friendship. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Welcome back. Located on the corner of Main and 4th Street, downtown Dubuque offers a hot new restaurant. The River Rock Kitchen and Tap is designed with Dubuque in mind. The rocks and earth tones inside the restaurant reflect the feel of the Mississippi River. The bar offers craft beers and tap and wine from the tri-state area. Something unique to the menu is the guacamole. A server makes it right in front of you, creating a fun personal experience. The combination of their menu and design of the restaurant provides an authentic feel, lining up with the goal of its founders.
Have as many people here in Dubuque enjoy what we've done to this space as possible.
The restaurant is open from 6:30 a.m. to midnight, Monday through Friday, with special hours on weekends.
Hordes of onlookers pass by every day, but how many know the story behind the big fluffy dogs found at Plume Retails? Reporter Rachel Choice dug up the story.
He got there. The first time I heard about it was I was just driving by and I saw like a whole bunch of giant dogs. We like immediately turned around and pulled in and went to see the dogs.
Plume Retail's co-owner Kim Eastman says the attention is unlike any they ever imagined.
We moved in here with our four dogs, but after a while so many people started coming in and taking pictures of the dogs and asking questions about them.
Author and owner Brett Terrell wishes more customers realized that it all began with his children's books.
It was a little frustrating in the beginning. All of a sudden they'd leave and they'd say thank you. Without taking home a book.
However, they learned to embrace the attention their canines bring. In fact, their popularity has only increased with Plume Retail's newest pack member.
It has exploded.
Causing business and the books themselves to really take off.
He has been awaited for weeks when we put him on Facebook. And everybody wanted to come and see him. So when he arrived, people were here right away before I opened the gate to see Nanook.
Of all eight dogs, Nanook is the first to have paid for himself in just one weekend. One thing is certain.
He's a very popular little man.
From the Mall Amusement Park in Galena, I'm Rachel Choice, LCTV News.
All right, those dogs are so cute.
They're the cutest dogs I've ever seen. They definitely bypass my dog. I'm really sorry, but
maybe. I want one.
We might have to take a trip out there this weekend.
Maybe we'll go visit the dogs. Anyways, it's time to recap the trivia question and give away some Happy Joe's trivia.
The Broncos took the football victory, but which commercial ad was named number one in the ratings? Was it A, Hyundai First Date, B, Doritos Ultrasound, C, Mountain Dew Puppy Monkey Baby, D, Budweiser Simply Put?
And the answer is A, Hyundai First Date. That makes Damon Davies our lucky winner. Congratulations, Damon, and thanks to everyone who played.
That's all the time we have for tonight. Don't forget to like us on Facebook at Loras College Television.
And follow us on Twitter at @LCTV_news. Sports Zone is back next week with the latest and greatest in Duhawk athletics.
We'll see you back here in 2 weeks. Thanks for watching and have a great night.